In this video, we'll distinguish between qualitative and quantitative data and how to classify data into four levels of measurement. Coming right up. There's two types of data. Qualitative data, which consists of attributes and labels, non-numerical entries, really. This is data expressed in words. It focuses on how people feel. It's things like surveys. And then there is quantitative data, and that's numbers that are measurements or counts, basically data expressed in numbers. Let's consider two examples. The softness of a pillow. It's kind of an opinion, isn't it? So that is qualitative data. How about if we measure the height of various tall buildings? Well, that's not much to argue about there. As long as we've measured correctly, that's quantitative data. A characteristic of data is the level of measurement. And that's what determines which statistical calculations are going to be useful and meaningful. There's four levels of measurement in order from the lowest to the highest. Starting from the lowest, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Nominal level of measurement is qualitative only. Ordinal can be either qualitative or quantitative. Interval and ratio are quantitative only. Let's start with an example of the lowest level of measurement of data, the nominal level. That's where data is characterized by names or labels. There's no criteria which would make sense to organize the data from first to last. You can't really do mathematical calculations with it. A good example is hair color. Now let's consider a quantitative example of ordinal data. And what you're seeing there is called a Likert scale. So when somebody takes a survey, and I'm sure you've had this experience, you might be asked, do you strongly agree, you're neutral, you are neither agree nor disagree, or you strongly disagree. And you can certainly rank these responses, but you couldn't say that strongly agree, you couldn't say how much more strongly agree is than just agree or neither disagree or agree in terms of a number. The two highest levels of measurement are quantitative data only. So the next one is interval level of measurement, and that means the data can be ordered and there are meaningful differences between the data, but there's no zero position on the scale. And the example I have here is of SAT scores, the Scholastic Aptitude Test, that about 1.6 to 1.7 million people in the United States take every year. When they are scaling raw SAT scores, they do not use the numbers from 0 to 200, and that's why this is considered interval data. The lowest score actually on the old SAT before it was redesigned in 2016 was 600. And out of approximately about 1.6 million people, only 324 people made such a low SAT score in 2014. Data at the highest level of measurement are ratio level data. And it's pretty similar to interval data, but zero means an inherent zero. That means that zero means none. So an example might be weight. If an object weighs 0 pounds, 0 kilograms, it has no weight. We can form ratios and do math with ratio level data. To summarize, we've seen there's two types of data, qualitative and quantitative, and there's four levels of measurement of that data. From the lowest to the highest, we go from nominal, which is qualitative only, ordinal, qualitative or quantitative, to the two highest, interval or ratio. Ratio is the highest because it has an inherent zero. I would like to invite you to like this video and subscribe to this channel. Thanks very much for listening.